Bibles, we'll take those out and turn to the book of Romans, chapter 8. I've got some scripture I'm going to read today in your hearing. And I want to thank God again for each one that's made their way out today. My old buddy Johnson back there, he's a mind reader, in case you all didn't know that. I'm sitting back there in the choir this morning. I looked out and he knew what I was thinking. I was thinking, where's half my people at today? And so he already knew what I was thinking. But anyways, do help me, okay? Reach out to people that you see's not here. Call them. Find out where they're at. Tell them we miss them. Tell them we love them. Tell them we want to see them back. They get that from me, but I found, it probably seems a little easier coming from some of you all. So if you all would do that, reach out to them, see where they're at. And, my prayer is, and you all know me well enough by now, anybody that's ever came through that back door back there, I want to see them here every single time the doors are open. And unfortunately, it don't always work that way. But, we want them to know that we miss them, and we want to see them here. So help me do that, if you will. Like I said, if you got your Bibles, I'm going to turn to Romans chapter 8. I'm going to start reading at verse 28. Very familiar verse of Scripture. Gets really deep, though, and I want to try to preach about that today. I thought about the thought today. Does anybody remember that song, "He's Still Working on Me"? Everybody know that song? You know the kids sing, "He's Still Working on..." I'm not going to make you all sing it, okay? Everybody relax. But you get the song, right? "He's Still Working on Me to Make Me What I Ought to Be." All right, so think about that while I preach this message. God's still working on me. Everybody agree with that? He's still molding me, making me Keith. And so, sometimes I like that, and sometimes I don't. Sometimes I don't like God working on me. Now, I don't know if you're like that or not, but, I've got this flesh that I deal with, and guess what? I've got some things that I just like. You know what I mean? Some things I just like doing, and there's a certain way. I'm just being honest. Some of y'all don't want to be, but you've got that twerk about you, too. You know what I'm trying to say. So sometimes when God works on us, it's not exactly comfortable. But anyways, we'll get into that. I find out as I get older, see if you can relate with this, as I get older, I realize more and more every day how God's working on me. Now, I see it a lot through Paxton. He teaches me a lot of things. Yesterday he taught me he'll run over me with a sled if I don't get out of the way. He teaches me things. And so, some of you guys, you're supposed to laugh a little. Come on. So anyways, as we get older, the more we learn, the better we're supposed to get at some things. You get that? I find the older I get, the better I should be at trusting God. The better I should be at relying on God. My patience should grow. And so, anyways, let's get into the scripture this morning. 28th verse in chapter 8, the book of Romans, says this, "And we know..." Pay attention to every word I read in this verse. 28 says, "And we know that all things," not just some things, "all things work together for good," not just halfway, not just maybe, but "for good to them that love God, to them who are called according to His purpose." Now, I could read a lot more scripture, but there's enough in that for me to preach for hours, okay? Not that I'm going to, but there is a lot of meaning in this verse. Let me read again. "And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are called according to His purpose." Now, I want to point something out to you this morning. This is a promise, okay? The Word of God, this Bible that I'm preaching out of today, is a book full of promises. So do you all believe every word that's in this Bible today? I hope you do. If you don't, then I probably ain't going to do much to help you today. But if you believe the Word of God, then you've got to believe that all things work together to good for them that love the Lord. Now, you pray attention, you pray for a few minutes. I thought about a lot of different things. Now, we know in life that, we're in the book of Job right now on Wednesday nights. And so, let me ask you a question. Was it a good thing that Job lost his children? That's a big negative. Was it a good thing that Job lost all his servants? That's a big negative. Was it a good thing that Job had bulls all over him? That's a big negative. Folks, you got to grasp the big picture, though. In the end, guess what? God worked all those things, and he brought them all together, and guess what? It was good, if you read the book of Job. Now, you pay attention, you think about that for a few minutes. I've thought a lot about, different things as God gave me this message. I thought about a diamond. Anybody, you ladies like diamonds, right? Yeah, preacher, we like diamonds. Yeah, let me ask you a question. That is a precious jewel. You all agree with that? And you men are going to say amen when I say this. When you go to the jewelry store to buy your significant other a diamond, guess what? They are expensive. Somebody say amen. They are... Y'all shopping somewhere else? Flea market? No, they're expensive, okay? Diamonds are expensive. You know why they're so expensive? Well, you know what really creates a diamond? It takes pressure and it takes heat, and that's what forms a diamond. Now, I want you to think about something. For you and I to achieve what God wants us to be in life, guess what? We have to go through some hard things, we have to go through some pressure, and we have to endure some heat. Are you with me this morning? We have to do some things that we're not comfortable with, some things that we don't like. Let's go to Genesis chapter 50. I want to read something here that God brought this to my attention in teaching the book of Genesis, and as we closed it out, it's something that Joseph said. We're going to look at Joseph this morning and part of his life, but if you go to Genesis chapter 50, well, it may not have been chapter 50. Well, we're going to pretend like it's chapter 50. How's that? This is what it says. After Joseph's brothers, here we go. Chapter 50, verse 19. See, I was right. Chapter 50, verse 19 says this, "And Joseph said unto them," talking about his brothers, "Fear not, for am I in the place of God, but as for you, ye thought evil against me, but God meant it unto good to bring to pass. It is this day to save much people alive. Now therefore fear ye not, I will nourish you and your little ones." And he comforted them and spake kindly unto them. Now, let's pick up here and let's get into the message today. Remember, he's still working on me. Joseph realized at this point his father had passed away, and guess what? His brothers thought, well, you know what? Now that dad's gone, you know what? Joseph's probably going to kill us, or Joseph's probably going to be mean to us, or Joseph's going to torture us, or Joseph's going to hate us, or whatever. But Joseph came to them, and Joseph came to a realization, Charles. He realized that his brothers meant bad for him, but guess what? God turned a lot of bad things into something really good. And so I want to look at that today, folks. I want you to realize something today. It doesn't matter what you're going through. It doesn't matter who you are today. We all face hardships, and we all go through things that we don't necessarily like. I thought about Joseph, and if you read the Old Testament, guess what? God sometimes asks people to do hard things. I think about when God told Abraham to take his son up on the mountain and to sacrifice him. I thought about how difficult that might be for Abraham to do. But, you know, Abraham was a man of great faith, and guess what? He trusted in God, and he listened to what God had to say to him. And I thought about in my life how many times that God asks me to do things that I'm not comfortable with, and the hard part is, Charles, is not knowing the future. Now, I'll be honest, the first Sunday morning that I walked into this place, if God could have showed me 3 years down the road and all the success and how good it was going to be and how much, you know, it was all going to be great, then you know what? I'd have just jumped up right then and said, "I'm your man. I'm the guy that needs to be here." But God expects us not only only does God expect from us, He requires us to have faith today. Do you all realize that? Faith in what? That He's able to do. You read through the Bible, and I thought a lot about Job, and as he faced into what the things that was going on, the first two chapters, you see how that he lost all these different things, Charles, and you notice how that he was still able to worship, and he was still able to praise God. The reason that Job was able to do that was he believed that God had a purpose for him. Now, let's go back to Romans chapter 8. Let's read that one more time, and then I'm going to give you the message. It says, "And we know," folks, you've got to know today that God has got a purpose for you today, okay? You're not just here by chance. You're not just here because He decided to leave you. Guess what? When God saved you, the Bible teaches us that He saved us to do a good work. And do you believe it's a good work today? I believe that this, Melinda's the only person in the building, believes this is a good work. I believe, everybody say, "Preacher, I believe this is a good work. I believe that today." If I didn't believe that, I'll be honest, I wouldn't be here this morning. You know what I mean? I believe this thing is good today. So, anyways, it says this, "We know that all things work together." Not just some things, not just a few things, but all things work together for good. Now, I don't know about you, but I want the good things in my life. How about you? I want good things. Charles, I want to be successful. I want to prosper. I want to be liked. I want to be accepted. Does anybody agree with that? We want all these things. And so all things work to good, together for good to them that love God. Let me ask you a question. Do you truly love God today? I want to know that. Not do you like God. Big difference today between liking God and loving God. And it's the same way with church. A lot of people just like church. You know what I mean? Guess what? If you just like something, then you're not going to sacrifice the way you should if you love something. You know what I mean? What do you think? Is that true or is that false today? If I truly love something, I kind of point towards Paxton, my little boy. I don't just like Paxton. Guess what? I love Paxton. And you know what? It'll make me cancel fishing trips. It will make me work harder. It'll make me do a lot of things. Why? Because I love that boy. Folks, we should be the exact same way towards God today. Amen? We shouldn't just like Him. We shouldn't just like church. We should love it. And guess what? If we love it, then guess what? It's a priority. You know what I mean? God's a priority in my life. Not only is God a priority, this church is a priority in my life. All right, so I want you to know something. If you truly love God, like the verse says, then guess what? You are looking for God's purpose in your life. Now, we're going to get to the rest of the verse. Let's pay attention. It says, "To them who are called according to His purpose." Listen to me today. God has got a purpose for you today. He's got a purpose for you being here. Believe it or not, He's got a purpose for me being your preacher today. And guess what? Believe it or not, He's got a purpose for you no matter where you're at in your life right now. God has got you there for a reason. And according to the Word of God, it's good. You know what I'm trying to say? It's good. Now let's look at Joseph. The Bible said that Joseph's brother sold him as a slave to the Midianites. Let me ask you a question. Do you think that was good? Do you think that Joseph was overwhelmed, was excited, was happy? Guess what? I went from being my father's favorite to being a slave. You think Joseph just got up one day and said, "You know what? I hope today that my brothers sell me as a slave." You think he woke up and said that? It's kind of like, you know what I mean? Last night I run into this preacher friend of mine, and he said he's not paying right now, and he said, "Preacher," he said, "I guess you're going home to study, aren't you?" And I just said, "Yeah, I guess so, you know." He said, "Well, I think I go home, kick back, and watch the ball game." Listen, folks, it's not, he don't got the pastor right now, so he can do that. I can't do that. Listen, it's not so much, let me ask you, did anybody just get up today and just say, "You know what, I just think I'm going to go teach Sunday school today," or "I just think I'm going to," Keith, did you do that today? It don't work that way, but guess what? God asks you and he asks me to do things sometimes that we're not comfortable with, and that, let's just be honest, we don't really want to do. But guess what? God asks us to do that. Why? Because he's got a purpose for us. And guess what? His purposes are good today. Amen. Now let's think about this. Joseph sold as a slave. But guess what? If Joseph had never been sold as a slave, then guess what? He couldn't have been found by Potiphar. Have you ever thought about that? And guess what? If Potiphar had not found Joseph, then guess what? Potiphar's wife couldn't have told a dirty lie on him, and he got put in prison. Now, let's talk about that a minute. Do you think, have you ever felt like that life just isn't fair? That things are just not going the way they should? And let me ask you a question. Have you ever thought to yourself, I don't deserve that? What do you think? I've done so good. I can see Joseph now crossing his arms, said, I've got that coat Dad made me. And you know what? I've had these dreams, and God's been working in my life. And you know what? Here I am now. And guess what? This crazy woman's told a lie on me. And guess what? I don't deserve this. Pay attention to me. Think about my whole message today. He's still working on me. You may not like, and guess what? You may, things might have turned bad for you, and maybe somebody told a lie on you. Or maybe this is that. Maybe you lost your job. Maybe you lost your friend. Maybe you lost a loved one. I don't have any idea. But guess what? You might be standing there saying, it just isn't fair. I don't deserve that. And guess what? You may be right, and you might be just in saying that today. But it still doesn't change the fact God's got a purpose for you. Huh? Guess what? If that woman had not told that lie on Joseph, then guess what? Joseph would have never wound up in prison. Anybody here ever been in jail before? Don't raise your hand. I would assume that prison is not, guess what, it ain't like jail is today. Not that I know, but guess what? They wouldn't cable TV, and they wouldn't three meals a day, and guess what? You didn't have that feather mattress, and not that I know, but you don't have all that stuff. You know, when they put Joseph in prison, guess what? It was not a good place to be. You may not exactly like where you're at in life right now. You know what I mean? Maybe you're facing health issues. Maybe I realize as I get older, guess what? I start growing here and I start losing here. You know what I'm trying to say? That's just the way it works. But as we go through life, Keith, I want you to realize something. All the things that we go through, they make us who we are. Do you all realize that? In other words, the hardships, the trials, the troubles, the tribulations. You know what I found out? The harder times that I go through, guess what? It makes me do. I cry out to God more. I cling to Him. I draw to Him. And guess what? That's truly what God wants from us anyway. He said He wanted to be close to us, closer than a brother. So listen, Joseph standing down there in prison wasn't where he wanted to be. Get it? Some of you lawmen back there, you know what I mean, right? Everybody gets in jail, guess what? They want one thing. They want out. I would assume Joseph wanted out of jail. If Joseph hadn't been in jail, he'd have never met, guess who? The baker and the butler. What do you think? Been hard to meet them if he hadn't been in prison. Guess what? He met two men down there, and they'd had a dream. Just so happens Joseph was able to do what? Interpret dreams. Guess what? If Joseph hadn't been in jail, he'd never got to interpret their dreams. And if he'd never got to interpret their dreams, then guess what? Word would have never got back to Pharaoh that, guess what? There's somebody down there in the jail that can interpret that dream you had. What do you think? You see the message? All things work together to good. Was it a good thing that he was sold as a slave? No. Was it a good thing that Potiphar's wife told a lie on him? No. Was it a good thing he wound up in jail? No. Was it a good thing that he was going to get to go meet Pharaoh? Starting to change a little, ain't it? I would have to think if I was in Joseph's shoes, I would see an opportunity there. You know what I mean? The Bible said that he got cleaned up and that he shaved and that I assume he started to look different. Folks, listen to me. Doesn't matter who you are, what you're going through, guess what? God has got a brighter day for you. Do you realize that? I want you to know that today. Things started to change for Joseph, Keith, when he walked out of the jail that day. You know what I mean? In other words, when he got an opportunity to walk up there and Pharaoh had this dream, and guess what? Joseph, I truly, truly, truly believe this with all that is in me. Joseph was the only man in Egypt, in Canaan, in anywhere else that was going to be able to interpret the dream that Pharaoh had. Guess what? You might just be the only person that is able to say some kind word to somebody that can lead them to God. Do you believe that? You might be the only person that's able to do that. But guess what? God might have to put you through the fire, through the flood, and guess what? You might have to go through some hard things, and you might go through some hard times, but know this, according to Romans chapter 8, verse 28, everything that is going on in your life today, if you love the Lord, He's working it out to be good for you according to His purpose for you. Y'all like this message today? Well, I don't know. If you don't like this message today, you ain't going to like none of my preach. I'll be honest. I just told you that everything that is happening in your life right now, God is going to make it good for you according to the Word of God. What do you think? You ought to be happy about that. Anybody here in the congregation ever made a mistake? Anybody ever made a flub? You know what I mean? Anybody ever fumbled before? You know what I mean? The last church before I came to this church, and guess what? I decided in my mind that I wasn't ever going to pastor again. You know what I mean? That was a mistake. And guess what? I mean, it's kind of like I started preaching at this guy's church, and I preached there once, I preached there twice, I was preaching there every month, and guess what I thought for was over with? He was probably about to leave, and I was going to be the pastor there, but it didn't work that way. See, God does not do things the way we think He will. Somebody say amen. I thought, I'm about to be over there in Morristown. You know, I'm going to be over there. Guess what? That old preacher by the name of Kenny Clark knowed Eddie McCubbins. And guess what? He called Eddie McCubbins and said, I heard you looking for a preacher, and here I am today. God does things in His way, not my way, not your way. But I have found out that, guess what? He works things together for good for them that love the Lord. Amen. Folks, we got a purpose. You realize that? You have got... Preacher, I lost my mom, I lost my dad, I get it, I know you, but pay attention, God said that He's working things together for good. Huh? How can something good come out of what I'm going through? I'm going to attempt to answer that. Joseph had been through a lot of pain, been through a lot of heartache for over 20 years. Joseph had been hurting for over 20 years. Do y'all get that? Had been in a place he didn't want to be around, people he didn't want to be around, doing things he didn't want to do. Guess what? Joseph had been there and he went through it. He'd been there, done that, and he had the T-shirt. You know what I mean? But guess what? There come a day that the prison doors come open. Joseph got to see some light. I hope and pray if you're in this congregation today and you're struggling, you're sinking, you're drowning, I hope and pray that through the message today, God speaks to you and you see some daylight. Huh? God's got it. Guess what? Joseph was the only man that was able to interpret the dream that Pharaoh had. And so guess what? Joseph went rolling in up there, and before it was over with, guess what? Even Pharaoh, which was a pagan, even Pharaoh realized that there was something different about Joseph's God. Is there something different about your God today? Is He like everybody else and everything? No, sir. My God is better. My God's higher. My God's greater. And my God is wiser today than anything the world's got. What about you? Yeah. Joseph rolled in up there, and guess what? Things started to change. Joseph didn't take no credit for it. He said, perhaps the Lord, whom I serve, will interpret that dream for you, King. All right, so if Joseph hadn't went through all those hard times, and guess what? He wouldn't be standing in front of Pharaoh right now. And if he'd never got to interpret the dreams, then guess what? Pharaoh would have never promoted him to be governor. Huh? I'm telling you that through and by God working things for good, that a man went from being a prisoner to being governor in a snap of a finger. Huh? That's the way it happened. Joseph, if you read the Bible, Joseph is a biblical hero. Do y'all agree with that? He's a hero. Let me tell you something. He didn't go from being a hero overnight. Huh? He had to have some heat and he had to have some pressure before he got to be a hero. You know what I mean? You and I are no different today. Huh? The things that we go through, the things we accomplish, the things we overcome, and guess what? The things we live through and survive, guess what? They define who we are. They make us what we are, and it's all through and by the help of the Lord. And guess what? It brings glory to Him. Huh? Ain't that what mine and your purpose is anyway? Guess what? Your purpose is not to be a millionaire. Your purpose is not even to be liked. Your purpose is not really to be any of that stuff. Your purpose is to glorify God. Huh? Let me finish up my message. Not only did he tell that dream, he got promoted to governor. And guess what? Just so happens, there was a famine in the land. People starving to death. And guess what? Guess who was sitting in the driver's seat? Pharaoh, preacher, he's the boss. Guess who was sitting in the driver's seat? The same man that said, you know what? We're going to have 7 good years and we better gather it up 7 good years. We better stockpile it. We better put it back because there's going to be a famine for 7 years and people are going to starve to death. Huh? What do you think? You're starting to get it now, right? Guess what? When everybody got hungry, guess who was hungry? Well, duh, preacher, the people didn't have no corn. Joseph's family back in Canaan got hungry. And guess who was able to provide what they needed? Joseph. Not only did Joseph have enough for them, he had enough for their children, he had enough for everybody. But guess what? If he had not went through the prison, if he had not been cast in there, if he had not been rebuked, if he had not been beat, if he had not been chastised, if the lie had not got told, then guess what? Joseph wouldn't have been sitting where he was at. And guess what would happen to Joseph's family? They'd have starved to death. Anybody sitting here in a congregation today, it's not really liking responsibility. That's not really liking leadership. What do you think? Anybody here like responsibility? I think it stinks. Huh? What do you think? What about accountability? And what about leadership? And what about responsibility? Anybody here in my church today sat here this morning, looked out at your Sunday school class and thought to yourself, man, they need to get a better teacher. Guess what? I must not be doing good. There ain't nobody here today. What do you think? Ooh. Do you realize, man, it got quiet just then. Do you realize that every one of you all are leaders today? Huh? You are leading somebody somewhere, somehow, you're leading somebody. Some of you mamas and dads need to realize the most important person you could ever lead, guess who, what? They're walking around about that tall right around your waist every single day. And you're leading them. You don't have the privilege, the opportunity, or the choice of saying, I don't like responsibility. I don't like being accountable. I don't like where I'm at. Come get you a song. I'm coming to a close. Joseph had a lot riding on him. Do you realize that? Anybody here today feel the pressure of life right now? Huh? What do you think? You got a wife at home, you got a husband at home, you got kids at home, you got a job, you got, you know what, sometimes I get to thinking to myself, you know what, I've got that whole church full of people counting on me, they're watching, and that's just a fact, it don't matter if I like it or not, it's just the way it is. I got Mandy and Paxton home, and guess what, I got all these men that work for me, and they're counting on me to eat. Sometimes, Keith, I get overwhelmed. Huh? Pressure. Heat. But Grover, there ain't no word quit. You know what I mean? Anybody here today want to quit? If you want to quit, I'm going to open the altar up for you. You need to come. You can't quit. You can't give up. You can't throw in the towel. There ain't nowhere to stop. You know what? On this road, on this journey that we are on going to heaven, guess what? There are not rest areas. You know what I mean? Well, let's just pull off and we'll take a couple years off and then we'll get back on the road and we'll start again. There is not anywhere to stop today. You get it? Man, I didn't like that part, Derek. Guess what? If Joseph was not able to provide, this is where it gets good. If Joseph could not have provided for his family, guess what would happen to every one of them? They would have starved to death and they would have died. Guess what happens if Joseph's family all dies? If they all die, guess what? The promised Messiah that would come through this tribe would have never been born. And guess what? If the Messiah was never born, then guess what? Jesus isn't here. And guess what? If Jesus isn't here, then guess what? You and I are dead in our sins and we're hopeless today. Y'all get that? If everybody died, then guess what? Jesus couldn't have been born. And if Jesus hadn't been born, some of y'all, I can see your eyes are rolling around. You're thinking, is that really the way it happened? That's really the way it happened. But guess what? It all started out by one old boy getting sold as a slave and thrown in prison. What do you think? It's all Bible. It doesn't really matter what you think. While you stand, I want you to think about something. This is something I'm going to preach about real soon, and it's going to be one of them bombs that goes off. You know what I mean? I mean like stuff flying everywhere. Do you realize that the way... Let me think how I'm going to say this so it'll come out the best possible. Do you realize that your opinion and what you think and all that good jazz... That God doesn't really care about that. Huh? What you think and what your opinion is about something does not change the way this Bible is written. Huh? James, just because I don't like part of it doesn't mean God's going to change it. Folks, God is not in the business of catering to everyone's thoughts and everyone's theories and what everybody likes. God's not in the business of catering to that. And as you can tell, I'm not really in it either. I like what the Bible says. You know what I mean? And the Bible says all things work together for good to those that love the Lord and are called according to His purpose. Doesn't matter where you're at right now, what you're going through right now, God's got a purpose for you. And guess what? The Bible said He's working it out to be good. Now I'm going to tell you what would really help you today while we give an invitation. This is what would really help you today. If you would just simply do one thing. Not like me. No, you don't got to like me. I hope you do. I hope you love me. That's not going to fix what's wrong with you. All you have got to do today, and this was what would help you today, is that if you would take this one verse of Scripture that I preached to you today, and you would believe it with your whole heart, soul, mind, and strength today. You would take this and you would believe this. You see if you don't change your outlook on where you're at right now. Joseph could have said 100 times, it ain't fair, it ain't right, I don't like it, all the above. But over in chapter 50, guess what he said? He said, you all meant it for evil, but God's turned it into good so that I could save your life and save everybody in this country. That's what a hero is. You know what I mean? You want to be a hero? Guess what? You don't get there overnight. While we sing, would you come?